Welcome back. Here we go. Wiring time. Yay! You're going to get to watch me get completely confused and frustrated, which is more fun than anything else. So, we've got our control box, and I've matched it up, and I've marked, you know, connector 2, connector 1, and connector 3. So they're all marked, so I know which ones are which. I have my coloring diagram that matches the connector I have, so we're good there. I've got my instructions, my pictures, my layouts, and all that sort of stuff. We've got all of our LEDs. We've got all the lights, everything else. The base is ready to go. So, and this will be going right on there like that. And then I finished this back off. I added this hard plastic straw. So I've got room to feed the wiring right down behind everything. So I will be drilling a hole through the base here. And then it'll just go straight through. And this will mount right in there. We'll have all of our switches up here and all that sort of stuff. So right now we're gonna kind of see where we're gonna end up with today. Just needed a nice project that'll get my brain kind of focused on one thing instead of all the other craziness going on in the world right now. So here we're gonna go. Oh, and we got the base all finished up. I got a nice coat on it. I think it looks really good. I'm really happy with it. So, I've had a couple comments on the YouTube channel, and so far the comments have been to make a clean saucer. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to make it just as it came out of the rocks. Right at, you know, just as it came out of the cylinder right after it impacted. You know, I got the got my iPad all set up to play War of the Worlds while I'm working. And what I'm going to start with is I'm going to start with the simplest section. And I am going to start by attaching the red or the iRay LED. Since it is fully wired with the resistor and everything, all I need to do is mount that in place and then run the wires down the cobra neck, get it all set to go. So that's what I'm going to start out with. Then I will probably just start on section 1, which will be the wingtip LEDs, which are here and here. Anyway, we'll just see what we can do. There will be a lot of head scratching. There will be a lot of me looking at things and flipping pages over. So just, I'll edit a lot of that out. And especially like the really, really interesting words I'm sure to come up with when I solder something to my finger. So with that being said, we're gonna go ahead and jump in and get started. So hold tight and we'll see where we end up. Here we go, kids. Thank you. So here we are. We have the bottom saucer section wired wired up. So I'm trying to match the wire colors so that I can attach everything. So, and I'm using hot glue to kind of tack everything into place. So the base is done. All I need to do is implant the little green lights, and they're good to go. So that's good. And then I've filed out areas on the wing tips here, and these lights will be going in there like so. Fit in there nice and tight. Then I'll tack these wires down. So one of those to each, and then there's another set that will be the firing lasers. They'll be in the front. Then we're going to be adding the green laser, or the green front, and that glues right against these pillars. I don't know if I'm going to go on the outside or the inside. They have theirs on the inside of the pillar. I don't know. I might go on the outside of the pillar just because I don't want any of those lights obstructed, even though it kind of, actually, it does kind of line up. So yeah, I could do it either way. So do that. And then, according to the diagram here, all the LEDs, so they're numbered. So, excuse my mess. So we've got the LEDs numbered. On the top, they're LED 1, 2, 3, and 4. And on the bottom, they're 5, 6, and 7. So LEDs 1, 2, 5, 6, and 7. So the two constant lights on the wingtips and the three base or ground leg lights are all wired together, and then they're wired to the positive and negative side of the LED strip. So obviously negative to negative, positive to positive. So, and then the negative goes to the brown line on connector number 3. The positive goes to the red line on connector number 2. Also, I've got the Cobra head assembled and wired, and it's got its three little wires down here. And the Cobra head, they go to separate lines, so that's in another instruction. So I'm gonna try and start putting this together in a way that I can make sure everything fits. I've punched a hole in the bottom, or in the base, so that the wires can go through. I've elongated the hole on the bottom of the saucer, so I got room for the wires to feed down into the straw that I put in. So at this point, it's just getting these wires attached and run properly. Now, what I'm thinking of doing is, once they're all run, I'm gonna send them one at a time through the base. And then I'm gonna label each one. So like all of these red wires for these will be red, will be labeled connector number 2, because all of these will combine down to one line that goes through to the base. So that wire will be connector number 2. All of these brown wires will go down to one brown wire, which will be labeled connector number 3. So that's how I'm gonna try and do it. I'm just gonna use extra wire. I'm just going to pull out a lot more than I need and just do it that way. I think that's going to be my best chance at doing this properly. All right, so let's get cracking. Be right back. Here's the deal. We got everything in the ship. We got all the wiring done. Everything run out the little hole. We've run into some issues. Number one, when I closed everything up, I ended up with this huge gap all the way around the saucer frame and all the way around here. So we filled that in with some tester's putty, which will need to be sanded. And then we're gonna have to go ahead and reprime and repaint the surface. Not a big deal, we can do that. The other thing we ran into is what I had planned to do with the base no longer is going to work. So we are going to go with some rods, hollow rods, to insert into the base and connect it down through to the main base. So that's our plan. So without any further ado, what we're going to do today, what we're going to do is finish up filing all or sanding all this down, prepping the surface for paint again, and then we'll call that the end of this video. And that's where we're going to go to right now. So hold tight, be right back. Ready to go. So, got it all sanded, got everything smoothed down. So now I'm just gonna tape over the areas that I don't want paint, and we're gonna get this thing repainted. And next time I come back, next video I upload, we'll probably be mounting it to the base and finishing off the last of the wiring to the main circuit board. So, as always, thank you for watching. Have a great day, and till next time, keep on modeling. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I hope you have a great day. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.